नमामि शारदां देवी वीणा पुस्तक धारिणीं नमस्कार करस्तु मी प्रसन्नास्तु ससदा। नाउ वी आर ऑन द सेवेंथ पार्ट ऑफ सेट्स। वी आर डूइंग द ऑपरेशंस ऑफ सेट्स। सो ऑपरेशन मीन्स एप्लीकेशन ऑफ सेट्स। वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट इंटरसेक्शन ऑफ द सेट, देन वी हैव स्टडीड डिसजॉइंट सेट्स, एंड नाउ यू आर गोइंग टू स्टडी union of two sets. Union means what? Combination, correct? So what I can lay A and B two sets, then the set of all elements of set A and set B is the union of two sets. It is written as A union B and read as A union B. Okay, see once again, union of two sets means we are having two sets A and B. The all the elements of A and B is called as what? The union of two sets, and it is written as what? A union B. I'll give an example for it. Example, suppose A is a set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. B is a set of 4, 6, 7, 8, and 10. Then, union of two sets, that is called as A union B. What you are going to write? You are going to write all the elements of A and B. So 1 is there, 2 is there, 3 is there, 4, 5, 6. But I told you that when I am going to write these elements, I am not going to repeat which are common. So which will not get repeated? 4 will not get repeated, 6 will not get repeated, but 7 will get repeated, 8 will get repeated, and 10 will be repeated. Have you understood this once again? What are the elements of A? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That it is, we have written that. But 4 is common, so I am not going to repeat it. But 5 is not there, I have write 5. 6 is get repeated, I am going to write once. You got it? 7 is there. Then 8 is there and 10 is there. This is called as what? A union B. Okay? So, Venn diagram, I'm going to write this. We have studied for intersection, same we are going to study for this. Which are the common terms? 4 and 6. 4 and 6. This part was actually an intersection. But it is, which are the remaining one? 1, 2, 3, 4, you should not write 5. So what you got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Why writing this? We are going to write 7, 8, and 9. This entire thing, whatever we are going to write, is the A union B. Have you understood this? This is the Venn diagram for A union B. And only this part is called as what? Intersection. But entire thing is called as what? A union B. Have you understood the concept once again? What is union of two sets? If A and 2 are the elements, you are going to collect both the elements of both the sets. The union of that collection of all the entire, all elements is called as what? Union. It is written as A union B. Correct? Read as A union B. And I have given the example. I have drawn the Venn diagram.
Please commit on it properly. Now we are going to study the properties of union of two sets, like how we have studied the properties of intersection of two sets. Same we are going to study the properties. We have to study six properties. First property is A union B is equal to B union A. Got it? What is the first property? A union B is equal to B union A. For example, I am going to take A is a set of 2, 4, 6, 8. And B is a set of 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You got it? So, what is the A union B? A union B is the total elements of A and B. So, I'm going to write 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 5, 6, then 7, 8, and 9. You got it? So, what is the B union A? I told you that we have to write all the elements. Order is not important. Then you have to start to write all elements of B. It is not necessary. You can write two, same way. 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So what you can say then? Therefore, A union B is equal to B union A. This is the first property of what? First property of union of two sets. Now we are going to study the second property of union of two sets. If A is a subset of B, A is subset of B, then I can say that A union B is equal to A union B is equal to B. We'll take example. A is a set of 2, 4, 6. And B is a set of 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. You got it? So, what will be A union B then? Then you have read all. So what happened then? 2 is there, 4 is there, 6 is there. That common terms you are not going to repeat. 8 and 10. If you compare these two, we come to know that. What is that? A union B is equal to B. See once again. If A is a subset of B, means all the terms of A should be in B. And when I am writing A union B, if I combine them, I am getting B only. So that's why A union B is equal to B is the second property of all properties of union of two sets. I am going to do third property. A is a subset of A union B and B is also a subset of A. See, I'll repeat it once again. What is that? A is a subset of what? A union B. And B is also a subset of what? A union B. I'll take one example. Say 2, 4, 6, 8 is there. First example I'll take. And B is a set of say 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So what is the A union B? A union B is a combination of these two. What is that? 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Have you understood this? So, if you compare this and this, all elements of A are there in A union B. Therefore, I can write that A is subset of A union B. And if you compare B, B, all the terms of B are there again, what? This A union B. So B is a subset of A union B. is the third property of what? Union of two sets. And if I am going for fourth property of union of two sets, that A union A complement is equal to U. Again, the complement word is coming, means what? You should have what? Universal set, is it right? So I am taking universal set as U. U is a set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 8 will take. Okay, no problem. Then, suppose A is a set of 2, 4, 6, and 8. All the terms are there, and U is a universal set. So what will happen in case of A complement? See, one second, A complement kya hota hai? Jo U mein hai aur A mein nahi hai, aise elements. So which are there? 1 is there, 3 is there, 5 is there, and 7 is there. Have you understood this? Now, if I am combining it, that is A union A complement, kya hoga hai? If I am going to combine it, I will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. If you compare now union set and A union A complement, I can say that A union A complement is equal to U is the fourth property of union of two sets. Got it? Now, we are going for the fifth property, that is A union A is equal to E. A union A is equal to A means A is a set of say 2, 4, 6 and 8. Is it right? So when I am giving the name to the other and I am taking the same element, I have to take what? A only, that is. So we will change order. 8, 6, 4 and 2. Both are A only. You got it? If I am combining A union A, what will happen then? We have to take the 2, 4, 6, 8 only. Because the other terms are get repeated. Repeated terms you are going to write once only. So, if I am comparing this and this, what I can write then? A union A is equal to A. Have you understood this? Now we are going for the fifth property. That fifth property is A union null set is equal to A. A union null set is equal to A. A is a set of say 2, 4, 6, 8. What do you become null set? Null set is nothing. Nothing is there inside. So what do we A union null set? Only I am going to take this. 2, 4, 6 and 8. Nothing is there in null set. So if you compare this and this, what I can say then? A union null set is equal to A. This is the sixth property of what? Property of union of two sets. I think you got this properties clearly. Okay, just comment on this. Saying we are going, I have written all the properties together. What is A union B is equal to B union A? If A is a subset of B, then A union B is equal to B. A is a subset of A union B. B is also a subset of what? A union B. A union A complement is equal to what? U. And A union A is equal to A. And A union null set is equal to A. You also write it once by pausing your video. Now, next concept is number of elements of a set. Total elements present in given sets. Total element present in a given set is called number of elements of set. Number of elements of It is written as N A. You got it? See once again. A is a set of say element 2, 4, 6, 8 and 9. Yeah, we take 12 also. So we have to calculate how many elements are there in this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 is there. So NA, number of element in A is 6. Have you understood the concept? Alright, suppose I will take one more example. I am taking B. B is a set of vowels in English, that is A, E, I, O, U is there. Right? It is. How many elements are there? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So number of elements in B is equal to 5. This is the actually number of elements of a set. Have you understood this concept? Please copy down this. Formula. Showing relation between number of elements of two sets, their intersection and union. Okay, see once again, the formula showing relation between number of elements of two sets, their intersection and union. So this formula is actually very important formula. हमें उसको बाहर करना है, याद रखना है. What is that? Number of elements in A union B. I repeat. Number of elements in A union B is equal to number of elements in A plus number of element B minus number of element A intersection B. I repeat. Number of elements in A union B is equal to number of elements in A plus number of element B minus number of element in A intersection B. See, I'll repeat it once again. Number of element A union B is equal to number of element A plus number of element B minus number of element in A union B. Okay, so they have not derived this derivation, but we can verify it. We'll take an example. और उसको वेरीफाई कर लेते हैं. ए इज अ सेट ऑफ से 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. बी इज अ सेट ऑफ 4, 8, 10, 12, 13 and 14. You got it? Then first of all we find out A union A intersection B. A intersection B will be what? Which are the common terms? 4 is there, and 8 is there, and 10 is there. And second one is A union B, means combination of these two, will be 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13 and 14. Have you understood this? So student, let's see. We are first trying to find out NA. Yeah, we write over here. Therefore, what will be NA? How many elements are there in A? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So NA is 5. What will be NB? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What will be the number of in A intersection B? So, this will be 1, 2, 3. And it is. And what is the number of element A? Union B. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Have you understood this? See once again. These are the things, huh? Which are that number of element A is what? 5. Number of element B is what? 6. Number of element A intersection B is 3. And number of element A union B is 8. You got it? So we'll check it that if this formula is very promise, iske liye verify hota hai kya? So what is that? Number of element A union B is equal to number of element A plus number of element B minus number of element A intersection B. Just check it. What is the value of this? Is 8. Is it right? What about NA? 5. What about this? 6. 5 plus 6 is nothing but what? 11. 11 minus 3. So I am getting 8 is equal to 8. This verifies it. Have you understood this? So once again, this is a very important formula. And this is the last concept of the sets. We have to just solve the problems after this. The formula showing relation between the number of elements of two sets, their intersection and union. So what is the formula? The number of element A and B is equal to number of element A plus number of element B minus number of elements in A intersection B. For that, suppose I have taken the example that A is a set of 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. How many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The number of element in set A is 5. B, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number of element in set B is 6. And number of element A intersection B is 3. And number of element A union B is what we got? 8. So we verified it. Number of element A in union B is what? 8. Number of element is 5. Number of element in set B is 6. And I subtract 5 plus 6 is 11, 11 minus 3 is 8. This is the formula to show the relation between two sets and number of element in A, their containing what? Intersection and union. So please copy down it properly. I think you have understood this concept very properly. Copy down this by pausing your video. Now we are going to start with the last practice set 1.4. See the first question. They have given that if NA is equal to 15 and A union B is equal to 29 and number of element A intersection B is 7, and they have asked you number of elements. For a while, pause this video. You try to do your own, I think you will get the answer definitely. I think you got the answer. Is it right? Which formula are going to apply? Solution. What they are giving you, NA is equal to 15, A union B is equal to 29, number of element A intersection B is equal to 7. So what you are going to write, we know the formula. What is the formula? Number of element A union B is equal to number of element A plus number of elements in B minus number of element in A intersection B. Substitute the values. The value of number of element A union B is 29. Number of elements in A is 15. Number of element in B, I don't know, minus 7. Now, for this what we can do is 29. We have to find the value of NB. So, I will take minus 7. This I am going to, on the same side only. So, it will become 15 minus 7 plus NB. That it is. So, what answer I get? 29 is equal to 15 minus 7 is 8 plus number of elements in B. So 29 minus 8 is equal to NB, or 21 is equal to NB. I got the answer. NB is equal to 21. I hope that you also got the same answer. If not, copy down this properly. क्वेश्चन तो थोड़ा सा ओके. नाउ आई टोल्ड यू दैट कोई भी टॉपिक ऐसे नहीं डाला जाता है, कुछ ना कुछ उसका एप्लीकेशन हमारे रियल लाइफ के साथ कनेक्टेड रहता है. इट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प यू फॉर द फर्दर स्टडीज. सो सी द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन. इन अ हॉस्टल, आई थिंक ऑल ऑफ यू नो द हॉस्टल, या नॉ, मेनी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स आर स्टडिंग एट होम ओनली, और घर के बाजू में स्कूल रहता है. But there are some students which are having some problems or like, so they are sent to hostel. Hostel एक building रहेगी जिसमें छोटे-छोटे rooms रहते हैं, अपने बच्चे वहाँ बच्चे stay करते हैं and अपना schooling complete करते हैं या colleges complete करते हैं. So in a hostel there are 125 students. Total hostel में कितने students हैं? 125. अब 125 student में से 80 स्टूडेंट्स ड्रिंक टी. कितने लोग चाय पीते हैं? 80. 60 ऑफ देम आर ड्रिंकिंग कॉफी, करेक्ट. अब वापस देखो, हमने 125 स्टूडेंट्स को जमा किया, अब बोला कि कितने लोग चाय पीते हैं, तो 80 स्टूडेंट ने हाथ खड़ा किया कि सर हमें, वी लाइक टू ड्रिंक टी. सो आई ट्रांसफर दे दिए वन. अभी आप लोग बाजू में खड़े रहो. हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स आते हैं? 80 स्टूडेंट्स आते हैं. फिर मैंने बताया कि हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट लाइक और ड्रिंक कॉफी, तो वापस कुछ लोगों ने हाथ खड़ा किया, तो मालूम पड़ा जो चाय पीने वाले थे उसमें से कुछ बच्चों ने भी हाथ खड़ा किया हुआ है. अब जो बच्चे बचे थे, करेक्ट, उसमें और जो हमने टी का बनाया था कॉन्सेप्ट, उसमें ऐसे मिला के कितने स्टूडेंट्स थे? 60, जिनका मैंने अलग ग्रुप बनाया. लेकिन और टी और कॉफी दोनों पीने वाले कितने स्टूडेंट्स थे? 20. उन दो ग्रुप में कॉमन थे. कॉमन का मतलब क्या होता है? इंटरसेक्शन होता है. इज इट राइट? तो थोड़ा सा आइडिया तो तुम्हें आ रहा है कि 20 स्टूडेंट, आई मेड अ ग्रुप ऑफ अ सेट ऑफ स्टूडेंट हु ड्रिंक टी, दैट इज सपोज ए, तो एन ए इज 80, बी इज अ सेट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स हु ड्रिंक कॉफी, तो एन बी इज इक्वल टू 60. एंड इंटरसेक्शन नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स, दैट इज ए इंटरसेक्शन बी इज 20. थोड़ा सा ये 125 के लिए ही गड़बड़ है, वो यूनियन है क्या? बट वी हैव टू रीड द क्वेश्चन प्रॉपरली, देन वी विल एबल टू जज इट. फाइंड द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट हु डू नॉट ड्रिंक कॉफी और टी. तो इस वक्त हमें आता है कि कुछ बच्चे ऐसे हैं जो चाय भी नहीं पीते और कॉफी भी नहीं पीते, बट वो अपने हॉस्टल में है, तो वो यूनियन नहीं हो सकता. Okay, means 125 students cannot be a union. Have you understood this? So, students, हमें hostel में जितने बच्चे हैं, उनको हमें एक universal set बनाना पड़ेगा. So, ऐसे question के लिए वापस देखते हैं हम लोग कैसा करेंगे solution. Let you be universal set of all the students in hostel. All the students in hostel. So it is a universal set, means I'll write union is equal to 125 students are there in a hostel, and that is because of this, because some students do not drink tea and coffee. So hum log isse universal banana hai. Please, you take care for this, because abhi is waqt ab log 9th mein hai aur thodi thodi bahut interesting cheeze seekhne ja rahe hain hum log, so you should be very careful. Have you understood this? So what I will do, I will take A. Let A be the set of students who drink tea. Correct? So, NA is equal to AP. Have you understood this? Then, I'm going to take late B be the set of students who drink coffee. Lisa? So, how many students in a group who drink coffee? 60. And B is equal to 60. You got it? I once again repeat it. हमने क्या किया, सब बच्चों को बुलाया, तो 125 स्टूडेंट्स आए, दैट इज अ यूनिवर्सल सेट. उनमें से हमने बोला कि कितने लोगों को चाय पीना पसंद है, तो 80 स्टूडेंट्स अलग निकले, तो नंबर ऑफ दैट इज अ सेट ऑफ स्टूडेंट हु ड्रिंक टी वो कितने थे, 80. फिर हमने बोला कि कॉफी कितने लोग पीते हैं, तो उन्होंने हाथ फिरा दिया, लेकिन कुछ बच्चे ऐसे थे जो 125 में से बचे थे, और कुछ वैसे ऐसे भी थे जो कि टी पीते थे लेकिन कॉफी भी पसंद है. तो ऐसे लोगों का ऑपोजिट ग्रुप बनाया, तो कितना हो गया, 60. करेक्ट. सो बट 20 स्टूडेंट्स ड्रिंक बोथ टी एंड कॉफी, देयरफॉर actually it is an intersection. The number of element A intersection B is equal to 20. Have you understood this? If hence we can write A union B, union kiya kiska, in dono sets ka, to usme kaun kaun se bacche milenge humko, who drink tea or coffee or both. Okay, so hence A union B is the set of students who drink either tea or coffee or both. So there are some students who drink, means I have, if I am taking A and B will be the set of student. Ya to chai peete hai, ya to coffee peete hai, ya to no peete hai. You got it? Now, hence, we have to find number of element in A union B. Is it right? We know that, which formula we know? Number of elements in A union B is equal to number of elements A plus number of elements in B minus number of elements A intersection B. So, number of elements in A union B is equal to, what are, how many students are there in A, that is 80. How many elements are there in set B is 60. And how many do not drink is what? Sorry, how many students drink tea and coffee is 20. So number of elements in A union B is equal to 140 minus 20. Number of elements in A union B is equal to, we got 120. Have you understood this? Let me check once again. 60, 80, and this one 140. 140 minus 20. So 140 minus 20, that is 120. So this is the answer. Is it right? Got it? See. So what is A union B? Is a set of students who drink either tea or coffee or both. So what we have to find out now? The number of students who do not drink tea or coffee. So I can write what? Number of students who do not drink tea or coffee is equal to. हमें कैसे मालूम पड़े कितने बच्चे लोग टी और कॉफी नहीं पीते हैं, कितने स्टूडेंट लोग हॉस्टल में? 125. सो दैट इज नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन यूनिवर्सल सेट. एंड दिस स्टूडेंट्स आइदर दे आर ड्रिंकिंग टी या फिर कॉफी या दोनों. दैट इज नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट ए यूनियन बी. सो अल्टीमेटली 125 माइनस 20, देर आर 5 स्टूडेंट्स who do not drink tea or coffee or both. This is a very important question. Very important question. So, see, we are making use of practical examples we are going to give. So, please, students, ये थोड़ा सा बच्चों के लिए difficult जाता है, but मुझे नहीं लगता कि हमारे बच्चों को ये question बड़ा भी difficult है. वापस मैं कैसे repeat कर रहा हूँ, देखो, in a hostel, there are 125 students. तो मुझे थोड़ा सा लग रहा था कि वो शायद ए यूनियन बी होगा, बट इन दैट 80 स्टूडेंट ड्रिंक टी, 60 स्टूडेंट ड्रिंक कॉफी, 20 स्टूडेंट डू नॉट ड्रिंक टी एंड कॉफी. अब उन्होंने पूछा वो डू नॉट ड्रिंक, सो दैट केस वी आर गोइंग टू टेक द नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट इन हॉस्टेल इज 125. ए हैव द टेकन द सेट एज वॉट हु ड्रिंक टी, दैट इज 80. बी इज अ नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट हु ड्रिंक कॉफी is 60, and 20 students are there who drink tea and coffee is A intersection. दोनों में combined is the common denominator of the intersection, that is 20. Hence, जब A और B लेंगे is the set of students who drink either tea or coffee or both. Hence, we have to find out what number of students A union B. We know that number of students A union B is equal to NA plus NB minus A union B. That is A union B is 80 plus 60 minus 20. 140 minus 20 is 120. अब 120 ऐसे स्टूडेंट्स हैं वो ड्रिंक टी और कॉफी और बोथ, या तो चाय पीते हैं या कॉफी पीते हैं या दोनों नहीं पीते. तो हमें कम करो वो डू नॉट ड्रिंक टी और कॉफी. तो पूरे हॉस्टल में कितने थे? 125. इसमें से टी कॉफी और बोथ पीने वाले कितने? 120. तो नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट डू नॉट ड्रिंक टी और कॉफी इज 5. This is the way you have to represent, and I think you have understood it properly. Pause the video and copy down it properly. Now the third question, again is a very common question that in competitive examinations, for the competitive examination the number of candidates are more. So for that particular section, there is a competitive examination. You might be knowing that for the Maharashtra government, there is an MPSC examination, that is a competitive examination, banking, then some students are applying for NDA, there is a competitive examination. So, like that, a simple competitive examination is there. Okay, so that is the competitive examination. 50 students pass in English. 50 स्टूडेंट जो थे वो इंग्लिश में पास हो गए. वेरी गुड. 60 स्टूडेंट पास इन मैथमेटिक्स एंड 40 स्टूडेंट पास इन बोथ द सब्जेक्ट्स. तो उतना तो मैं आइडिया आ गया. दिस इज अ सेट ऑफ स्टूडेंट हु पास इन इंग्लिश एंड ए इज आर सपोज मिसिंग एन ए ओनली. एन ए इज 50, मैथ्स के 60 है. And both मतलब intersection is 40. Is it right? अब luckily none of them failed in both the subjects. पहले में क्या था, पहले question में कुछ student tea और coffee दोनों पीने वाले नहीं थे. यहां पे वो issue है ही नहीं है, because none of them, कोई भी बच्चा दोनों subject में fail हुआ, at least वो एक subject में तो pass हुआ ही है. And what I asked you, number of student who passed in at least one subject. So it is a very easy question as compared to first question. So
See how we are going to do it. Solution. Let A be the set of students who passed in English. Who passed in English. So ultimately, NA is equal to 50. Is it right? Then let B be the set of students who passed in mathematics. So ultimately, NB is equal to 40. No, 50 is 60. You got it? Have you understood this now? And so A is a set of students who passed in English, and B is the set of students who passed in mathematics. आप लोगों को ये तो idea मिला कि हमने union set लिया नहीं, because none of the students is failed in both the subjects. Then 40 students passed in both the subjects. So A, number of students in A intersection B is equal to 40. Are you getting it? NA is equal to 50 and B is equal to. So then they have given a statement that you mentioned. None of students fail in both the subjects. एक भी बच्चा fail नहीं हुआ है. Okay, the students. Appear for examination have passed in at least one subject or both the subjects, right? At least one subject. Therefore, A union B is the set of students who passed at least one of the subjects. At least मतलब क्या है? They might be clear both the subject, but एक तो subject उन्होंने clear किया होगा. You got it? So as we know, what we know, number of students A union B is equal to NA plus NB minus number of element A intersection B. Substitute the value. NA is 50 plus 60. Minus 50 plus 60 is 50 plus 60 is 110 minus 40 is 70. That is the number of students who passed in at least
one of the subject is equal to 70, and that you have to put in a bracket. I repeat this question. In a computer examination, 50 students passed in English, 60 students passed in mathematics, 40 students passed in both of the subject. None of them is failed. Ek bhi bachcha fail nahi hua hai. That's why we are not taken a union, otherwise we should have taken a union. So, universal set. Find the number of students who passed in subject. We should have taken the union as a student who appeared for the examination. But ek bhi bachcha fail nahi hua, toh appeared matlab सबके सब बच्चे जिन्होंने अपीयर किया था सबके सब बच्चे पास हो गए एटलीस्ट इन वन सब्जेक्ट. सो द नंबर ऑफ आई टोल्ड यू दैट दीज आर द स्टूडेंट पास इन इंग्लिश, दीज आर द स्टूडेंट पास इन मैथमेटिक्स, दीज आर द स्टूडेंट हु पास इन बोथ द सब्जेक्ट्स एंड नन ऑफ देम हैव फेल्ड मींस ए यूनियन बी इज अ सेट ऑफ स्टूडेंट हु पास एटलीस्ट इन. तो मैथ्स से फेल पास हुए तो शायद वो इंग्लिश में फेल हुए, इंग्लिश पास हुए तो मैथ्स में फेल हो गए, या दोनों में पास हो गए. इज इट राइट? सो एज वी नो दैट इज द ए यूनियन बी, ए यूनियन बी इज इक्वल टू एन ए प्लस एन बी माइनस ए इंटरसेक्शन बी, यू गॉट 70. 70 इज द स्टूडेंट हु पास एटलीस्ट इन वन सब्जेक्ट, मीन्स वन सब्जेक्ट और बोथ द सब्जेक्ट्स. हैव यू अंडरस्टूड दिस? दैट इज द आंसर. कॉपी डाउन इट. दिस इज अगेन वन मोर प्रैक्टिकल एग्जामिनेशन एग्जाम्पल, सॉरी. बट आपके टेक्स्ट बुक में इतना बड़ा क्वेश्चन लिखा है कि ऐसा लग रहा है मैंने ऐसे लिख दिया. ओके, तो ठीक है, नो प्रॉब्लम. विल सी दैट क्या है क्वेश्चन. अ सर्वे वाज कंडक्टेड, सर्वे कंडक्ट किया टू नो द हॉबीज ऑफ 220 स्टूडेंट्स. कितने स्टूडेंट्स है? 220 स्टूडेंट ऑफ द क्लास 9th. ओके, आउट ऑफ which 130 students inform about their hobbies as a rock climbing, 180 students have students about their hobby as a sky watching, there are 110 students who follow the both the hobbies, then how many students not have, ये एक point आ गया, like who do not drink tea and coffee वाला, any of these two hobbies में जो survey किया था हमें universal set लेना पड़ेगा. How many of them follows the hobby of rock climbing only, वो निकाल सकते हैं. How many students are having a hobby of sky watching only, that also you can easily find out. So I told you that how many students do not have any of two hobbies, means kuch bachche nahi hai. To jo conduct ke liye usme se kuch bachche nahi hai, usme kya lete hain? Universal set. To please zara you have to, I am writing in small handwriting, so try to take it properly. मैं explanation करते हुए पूरा पूरा ले रहा, तुम लोग ध्यान दे दो कि मैं क्या explain कर रहा हूँ, and according to that you are right. Then let number of total number of students or let u be the, we have to write solution, u be the universal set of students in survey. So number of students in who are there is there in a survey is number of element u is equal to 220. The survey was conducted to know the hobby of 220 students. So I have taken the number of total students conducted, numbers that u be the universal set of the student in survey is 220. Is it right? In that, out of that, 130 students inform their hobby as what? Rock climbing. So let A be the set of students who have hobby as a rock climbing. Rock climbing. So NA is equal to 130. Then let B be the set of students who have hobby as sky watching. So NB is equal to how many students are having? That is 180 students. So I will take it as 180. Is it right? So there are 110 students who follow both the hobbies. See once again. कितने लोगों का स्टूडेंट का सर्वे निकाला था? 220. तो वापस जैसा पहले किया था वैसे हमने किया है. टू स्टूडेंट और एक हॉल में कितने बच्चे लिए? 220. उन्होंने पूछा कि किसको अच्छा लगता है रॉक क्लाइंबिंग एज अ हॉबी है जिसकी, तो देवर 130 स्टूडेंट. हमने उनका एक ग्रुप बनाया जिसका नाम दिया, जिस सेट का नाम दिया ए, एन ए इज इक्वल टू 130. फिर हमने पूछा हु इज हैविंग हॉबी ऑफ स्काई वॉचिंग. तो कुछ लोगों ने हाथ करा, बट देयर वर सम स्टूडेंट्स इन सेट ए, दे आल्सो हैविंग अ स्काई वॉचिंग एज अ हॉबी. उनको एक साथ बना दिया जिसके स्काई वॉचिंग है, इसलिए क्या होगा? 180. बट ऐसे there are 110 students who follow both the hobbies. That is nothing but that is for number of elements in A union B is equal to 110. अब हमें देखना है कि at least one hobby वाले कितने students हैं. So therefore we can write that A union B is the set of students who have at least one hobby of rock climbing or sky watching. Is it right? Therefore, so as we know, number of elements in A union B is equal to number of elements in A plus number of elements in B minus number of elements in A in the section B. That is equal to 130 plus 180 minus 110. So that will become 130. And if I cancel it, becomes 70. So 130 plus 70 is actually 200. You got it? So, 200 ऐसे स्टूडेंट्स हैं who are having either this, they are having both of their hobbies as a rock climbing or sky watching. If you see the first question what they have asked you, then how many students do not have any of the two hobbies? So we are going to write, therefore, number of students not having any hobby, any of two hobbies is equal to, हमने जो सर्वे किया था उसमें से एटलीस्ट वन वाला हमें सब्ट्रैक्ट करना है. That is equal to 220 minus 200 is equal to 20. ये तो हमें मालूम पड़ा. Is it right? अब दूसरा जो क्वेश्चन है ना, how many students follow the hobby of rock climbing only? उन्होंने पूछा कि खाली रॉक क्लाइंबिंग, वो नहीं चलेगा कि मुझे दोनों आता है, नहीं तो आई इंटरेस्ट खाली रॉक क्लाइंबिंग में किधर है, वो पूछा है उन्होंने. सो वी हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल व्हेन आई गिव आंसर. तो व्हाट यू गुड राइट, नंबर ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स हैविंग hobby of rock climbing only. Only rock climbing. तो ये जो set था ना, 130 students, उनको rock climbing था, but इसमें दोनों आते हैं, जिसमें ऐसे students हैं, they are having रॉक क्लाइंबिंग एज वेल एज उसमें भी इंटरेस्ट है. हमें वो नहीं चाहिए, वो चाहिए जिसमें खाली रॉक क्लाइंबिंग अच्छा लगता है और दोनों अच्छे रहने वाले स्टूडेंट नहीं है. तो दैट टाइम वी आर गोइंग टू टेक एन ए प्लस एन ए इंटरसेक्शन बी. प्लीज स्टूडेंट, दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग वी आर टू. सो एन ए इज इक्वल टू, वी आर हैविंग हाउ मच, 130 माइनस 110. Again, answer is 20. And last question is, number of students follow the hobbies of only sky watching. So, with that, we are going to write it. So, what are you going to write then? Number of students having hobby of sky watching. Only that time also NB minus A intersection B lenge. So that NB is 180, I think. 180 minus 110, 70 is the see. You have to take this question very properly. सर्वे वॉज कंडक्टेड, सो 220 स्टूडेंट का सर्वे किया था, उसमें से 130 स्टूडेंट्स को हॉबी एज अ रॉक क्लाइंबिंग अच्छा लग रहा था, 180 स्टूडेंट्स को स्काई वॉचिंग अच्छा लग रहा था, 110 स्टूडेंट को दोनों अच्छे लग रहे थे. बट व्हेन दे हैव आस्क्ड हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट डू नॉट हैव, इसका मतलब 220 में से ऐसे स्टूडेंट्स है जिनको रॉक क्लाइंबिंग वगैरह अच्छा नहीं लगता है, जो ए के साथ भी कनेक्टेड नहीं है, बी के साथ भी कनेक्टेड है, ए इंटरसेक्शन ए यूनियन के साथ भी कनेक्टेड नहीं है. इसलिए हमने ये जो स्टूडेंट थे उसको लिया यूनिवर्सल से. यूनिवर्सल सेट इज हाउ मच, 220 ऑन विच द सर्वे इज कंडक्टेड. ए इज द सेट ऑफ स्टूडेंट हु आर लाइक रॉक क्लाइंबिंग, बी इज द स्टूडेंट 180 स्टूडेंट हैविंग अ हॉबी एज अ स्काई वॉचिंग, 110 स्टूडेंट हैविंग हॉबी ऑफ बोथ, दैट इज ए यूनियन ए इंटरसेक्शन, सॉरी आई मेड मिस्टेक, इट इज ए इंटरसेक्शन बी. Okay, A intersection B is the both. So what will happen now? So A union B with a set who like at least one hobby as rock climbing or sky watching. So A union B is equal to, we got 200. So what they have asked you, how many students do not have any hobby? तो हम लोग यूनिवर्सल सेट से कट करेंगे, तो यूनिवर्सल सेट में करें 220 माइनस दिस वी गॉट एट लीस्ट वन हॉबी वाले वी गॉट 20. दे आर आस्क्ड ओनली रॉक क्लाइंबिंग, मींस वी डोंट वांट द स्टूडेंट हु आर हैविंग रॉक क्लाइंबिंग इज अ सेट हु हैविंग ओनली रॉक क्लाइंबिंग एज वेल एज सम स्टूडेंट्स आर देयर दे लाइक टू वॉक स्काई वॉकिंग स्काई वॉचिंग ऑल्सो. सो व्हाट दैट In that case, we have to subtract 110, so what will happen then 20, same thing we got only rock climbing will be a NB minus A intersection B is 70. Copy. Again, this is a fantastic question. Last question of your exercise, practice set 1.4 ka. Okay, it is a practice set 1.4 ka field question hai. Now, whatever you are studying, what is Venn diagram, what is union, what is intersection, all these things are there. So, observe the following Venn diagram and write the following sets. First of all, you have to find out set A. Set A is the answer for first. How many are there? How many elements are there in set A? X, Y, Z, M, and N. I think you got the answer. They have asked the second question as what? Solution. Set B. What is the B? This part. That is B is having M, N, P, Q and R. Third question is A union B. Then, if when you are very much confident that we have written in proper way, then no need to see the figure and you have to combine this. What is that? X, Y, Z, M, N, P, Q, and I. Have you understood this? X, Y, Z, M, N, P, Q, and R. No need to see the figure, or you can see the figure and you have to perfect all this. Fourth question. Universal set. Universal set is the entire figure. So, U is a set of, I will start with A. A mein kya hai? X, Y, Z, M, and N. And it is. Now, B ka part kya rahega? P, Q, R. Na? P, Q, R. M and N are not going to rotate. Aur kya raha gaya? S and T. So, this is the universal set. You got the answer for this again. Now what they have asked you? Fifth one is A complement. A complement means A you have to compare with universal set. Which are that? X, Y, Z, M, N chhod ke jitne bhi rahenge wo na. That is P, Q, R, S and T. I think you understood what the meaning of that. You have to compare with universal set and A. Then they have asked you B. So sixth one is B complement. Again B complement you have to compare with A. In that M, N, P, Q, R is there. Means what is not there? B complement is X, Y, Z, S and T. And it is. And last one is A union B complements. A union B complement is compared with universal set. That is question number 7. That these terms are there. Means you have to compare with universal set. And this, all these should not be there. Only which terms are left? That is A union B complement is equal to S and T is only the terms which are there in which are there in universal set but not in A union B, that is SMT. I think this is a fantastic question. You understood it properly. Copy down it. And okay, this is the end of your part 7 and we have completed all the practice sets. Copy down properly.